I have mixed up some colors already previously to this. Now we're going to apply them. Now I've done a small drawing in pencil here, and we're going to take a middle-sized brush, number 4, and we're going to begin. This is fairly complex, so exactly where to begin, it's a good question. I've mixed up some darks and so on, so we're going to apply some of the darks to the dark areas right now. And you'll notice that there's a lot of them. There's a lot of dark areas in this painting, but there's a lot of lights too. There's more dark than light, and that's what you want in a painting. You want either 2/3 darks and 1/3 light, or two-thirds light and 1/3 dark, one of the two. Now I'm adding a little bit of cat orange to this mixture, and I'm just placing on here. There's a cedar tree on the left here, and that has some reds in it, and so this is warming up some of those darks. The darks are made from Alizarin Crimson, burnt umber, more specifically. So we're just going to put some of those in. It's darker on the shadow side, so we'll just put a little bit more ultramarine blue there. I'm adding a little bit of terps to this because it's more of a drawing. We're drawing it sort of in some manner. There's a lot of them. A lot of mixtures here that a lot of limbs and trees and so on that I have not put in there. We're just going to have to play that beer by ear, because pretty hard to put it all in there at the same time or all at once. There's a kind of a purplish dark mixture in the back, and we're going to add that right now. And was pre-mixed. Same colors as a brown, only we've got some reds and we've got some blues, more blues in it. This is kind of covering the canvas, first of all. You want to get the values sort of halfway right in the beginning stages. Sometimes you think they're too dark because it's on this white surface. Be careful about that. They might be too dark or too much light. You have to... They might be too light when you think they might be too dark because they are... You're putting them on at such a light surface. So that's why a lot of people pre-tone their canvas. Adding a little bit of Alizarin Crimson to this. Looks like it's a little bit redder in that area. And so I'm doing that. As you can see, they're all fairly dark colors there. But, see that this tree has a dark, of course, they're all darker on this outside. Here we've got fairly good dark. This is a more of a grayer blue brown I'm using here, almost similar to some of the what I'm going to be using down here for the shadows, tree shadows and so on. Looks to be a little bit redder in that area, so I'm adding some more red. And I'm going to add a little bit more red up here too. Kind of a... There's some sky peeking home through here, so I'm not going to totally do that. So, see some of these shadows are up here too. There's some grayer shadows are up in here. That's from all of the trees, the very, very small branches far away are getting a little bit redder. And more towards the purple side. I see all right, I'm going to have to place a few of these tree here. Try to figure out exactly where that's going. This is a twisty old gnarly tree here, and so want to get it in there. Very gnarly tree. It looks almost off balance here. And I've got about 2-3 mixtures of this dark here. Want to make sure that these trees are thicker at the bottom than they are anywhere else, and they must taper everywhere. Otherwise your tree is not going to feel like it's stuck into the ground or is securely set into the ground. So ensure that you know that, have that done. So we'll put some of these trees in here. Whoa, this is a mess. This is kind of complex, isn't it? And my drawing, you know, it's not that complete. Pick out some of the major ones and try to get those in. Get some of those in, that'll help a little bit. Okay, we're back again. I had to change out cards. It was all totally full, so. Alright, so we're in the middle of this here. And I'm just placing in some of the major tree limbs here that I see. I'm going to include some of the some shadow color back here. Maybe that'll help me define some of these areas. As you can see, the shadow area is fairly dark. All right, we're continuing to apply color to the canvas, and there's a limb right here. there's a shadow area right in here too. Yellow white, kind of white with some yellow ochre in it. Not yellow ochre, but cad red, cad yellow. Excuse me. And I'll just put that in arbitrarily. Notice the brush is fairly big yet, even though everything is pretty small. Don't want to go too okay, so right in here it appears that's fairly blue color on that roof. We'll put that in here. There's a right here, there's a dark window. That angle down, there's another. And so that roof would be right here. And it's gonna trail off in that manner. So right at the moment, we'll just fill that in. There's same, mixing the shadow color with cad yellow light mixture. And we're just gonna put that in. Notice it's still pretty dark. Some kind of a light is hitting that rain gutter along there, and so I'm lightening it up, lightening this up just a little bit. A little bit lighter right here, it gets darker down below. And we're going to, with a darker mixture of ultramarine blue, and the dark we're using for this tree, we're just going to put that window in. We're going to do the same thing up above. And that window goes, here's the top of the, so it is right about there. And it's a little one, so we'll leave that right there. This is some more of that mixture that we had for that area back here, which is likely the kitchen area. It's an add-on. Looks to be something on that order. And we're just going to throw this in here. Noticing that we're cutting into the tree now a little bit. It's a little bit darker, still the darker area. So, but it is lighter, I mean darker, is darker than this light area coming across, of course. There's shadow colors falling all over the place here. I don't want to get all caught up into that stuff though yet. So let's, it looks very bluish though. Very blue and lightened out there for some reason. I think because of how the light's hitting it. So let's put it in the same sort of manner. Okay. There, for right now, good enough. Let's go on to this area over the porch. And that's right here. It comes down very hard edge, like right down there. You gotta be, you gotta know what you're doing when you're doing this. You can't hope for a lot of happy accidents. You gotta pretty much know what you're doing. What's really nice is that oil is very forgiving. Very forgiving medium. Okay, this is very light here, so put that in pretty light. Right at the moment, we'll just put it in there, and we won't worry about all that detail there. Let's go on from there. As you can see, my white that I'm using, mixture of cadmium yellow light, and it's actually darker. what we see in the picture. And I do that for some reasons. I wanted to reserve that light so I can put it right where it should be later. It's almost a greenish, yellowish light. And I'm just going to put this in. Notice that this goes from this peak right here. Gotta remember that in this case, it's two-point perspective that we're using. Here's the horizon line about. It's way over here, way over there. There's a point, and all the lines are over here are converging onto that point. Over here, way off the canvas, there's a point where these are converging. See right here? Okay, that's converging, going down here. Okay, here I'm a little off, see? So I'm going to change it a little bit, put it down. Right now. There we go. Okay, and then there's some light on top of this, of course. Okay, we're going to go back to this color and make sure that that is comes down there like it should. Okay, so what have we got so far? We've got to do this. We'll do the light of the house right now. This right here. Up here. I'm not worrying about that light right at the moment being real accurate, because I'm going to spice that up and hit that light later. I'm going to put a shadow there. I actually don't see that shadow because there's a limb actually hidden there. It's unfortunate in some ways. So okay, so got kind of a mixture so the darker mixture the houses perspective-wise is falling down here, going down this way. Here we've got a real dark shadow, really dark, right in there. And so we'll put it in there. We'll put it in there. Look at your values all the time. Value, value, value. That's what matters. Here we go with that same mixture. Over here, that's over here. And to me, it has a little bit of redness, or so I'm gonna add a little bit of red and orange, a little bit of that. Almost too much, so I'll take some out. So we're just going to put that in there. And it appears to go down here. This area and then into this area. It appears like I got to darken this limb up here so you can see it. Comes down here, goes out there, comes down on this side. There's one that comes down here, travels back into this area here, and forms this kind of. Then this comes back here and here, so we get this blob of darkness right there. All right, so let's look at this area now. Kind of going around here. A little bit of this still back there. A little bit here. I see some along this back side here. And then there's some in the back on the ground here. And this is on the ground. Much, a little bit darker than this tree is. So I'm gonna play dark off a lighter. Okay, so like I said, to lighten this up, then okay, this is very complex here, so don't get worried about it. It's not anything we have to really concern ourselves with yet. I'm going to make some darker ultramarine blue, burnt umber, and I'm coming in here. I don't use black very much. I have it in my palette, but I don't use it hardly. See this dark limb coming down here? I lose it right here. So I'm going to lose it there too. Okay. If you try this for the first time or something like that, don't get disgusted over yourself. You're doing fine. Don't worry about it. I'm graying a blue mixture that I have here. This is cerulean blue mixed with some of this color. See, I'm missing. Windows. Tools. There, now I won't jump back and forth. My reference was back and jumping forth. Jumping back and forth all the time. And that was really kind of aggravating. Okay. I'm just kind of including. There's a light up. There's a blue mixture. It's back there. It's kind of, you're looking through the trees. Through the trees. And so, you just, you hint at things. This is where it gets kind of exciting when you can watch this happening. You wonder, how the heck does that guy do that? Heck if I know. Yeah, so. Gotta watch out that you don't overdo things. Kind of try to understand your tree. Every tree has a personality. You want to get that personality down there. Okay, so right about here, there's this opening. There's something happening right here. So, redefining some of those areas there, it appears like there must be some kind of tree here, because it goes down in that manner. Looks, appears like that tree comes out jutting and is literally in the back of this tree. That's what it looks like, and you know what? That's the way it should be, and it's lighter. It's lighter, so it's back here, and he's right there. That little Umber was hiding on me. Yeah, he was hiding on me. this one has some girth to it, so you have to make sure that that thing still is heaviest at the bottom. Just like this little tree here, it's going to be a little bit heavier at its bottom. Alrighty, let's see. Now it looks, it appears like, Alright, we continue on in the struggle of the painting. So, mix up the darker. This is the basement there. I mean, not basement, but the walkway. It's a foundation that it's found on. I guess you could say it's that. So I'll put that in. Evidently there's snow there, so it rises. Then of course it's here again, and you'll see it here again. Hit some of this up here a little bit more. Appears like there's some lot of trees, a lot of the same old tree. He's all over the place. I'm going to have to scuttle him in a little bit here. A little bit up here. And across here. He's pretty thick in here, this area. Now it's easy to get on one like this to get aggravated and almost like, this is too hard, I can't do it. You just keep on plugging away, because you can. Don't get a defeatist attitude. You squint and put in that area, some of that, or those areas that you think might require some of this. All right. So, I'm going to add some light to this bluish mixture, and I'm going to put some in here. Let's see now. Okay. Notice that the combination of this brushwork here I'm kind of in cutting in and finding those branches. I'm cutting in and finding those branches where they might work. So we have a dark one up here, so we'll cut that in. I don't think you'll find too many artists that tackle a subject this difficult. On a video, YouTube video. They always try to make it pretty easy. But I'm showing you how it's done. How you should not get discouraged over it. Because it's easy to get discouraged. Yeah, it's easy to get discouraged. I'm still got the same old brush I've been using. I'm going to go to a smaller brush now. And I might come back to it, to the larger one. But let's see what we have. Use a flat number. Don't know what number. Looks like about a 2. So. It's an involved tree, all right. That'd be a good challenge. In fact, it's so involved, I can hardly tell what's going on there. Yeah, it is interesting. That's for sure. As I'm doing this, I'm finding out that I'm not actually looking at this reference as much as I am just kind of what would this tree probably look like, because I can't understand it. It's too involved. So I am trying to simplify. Trying to simplify because it's just too much. Even I am having my problems. So I'm going to throw in some blues just to kind of set some of this down. The darker, the darker blue will be darkest up on the top, towards the top. So it's coming along, we can see some progress. The bigger the sky hole, the lighter it'll be. Oh, I'm not worried about that so much right now, because I just want to fill up, get this block in pretty much done. Let's see now. Well, it's coming along, but it's a long way from being there. If you look at a tree, you squint at it, all the little branches become a darker shade of sky, or of the normally purplish kind of situation. So let's go and hit this building up a little bit here. What is this? This is, sun will throw some of this building and its roof and so on. You'll see what look appears to be, you know, a tree on the house, and that's part of the shadow being cast upon the. Here's that, and here's the other side of that. It goes down in this manner, so this is a little higher right here. But it's hard to see. Right here is the just a reflection off of that gutter a little bit again. Right in there. Okay. Let's put that. We'll put this one in right here. What you want to do when you're drying, you want to put these windows in as less amount of steps as possible. And the way you do that is to have a brush that is about the same size as these windows. So you can press down, pull down, put that window in. This is the screen door, I think. This is a larger window back here. And, it looks pretty darn big compared to that. I think I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. Okay, and we're gonna get, I'm gonna get kind of like a gray, bluish mixture. Still should be some ultramarine blue in there. And we'll put it in. There we go. There's a little bit of reflective glare right there on that edge. And just put it in. There's that little cross piece there, and maybe something right there. All right, that looks good. Now let's tackle these. They're kind of grayish, reddish, brownish, more reddish. Let's put that in. Each one of these. It's kind of fun, isn't it? Okay. This is kind of yellowish. This is yellowish, goldish, yellowish, purple. Let's put that in. It appears to be a little bit darker. We want to now lighten that up a little bit. Lighten that up a little bit and put that in. Okay, next one is a combination thereof. It's a little darker on the top. And lighter on the bottom, which you'll add right now. Notice that there isn't much. I'm just going to kind of pull a light across there and pull them also together as a result. I'm going to also then increase a little reflection on this one and a little bit more on this, a little bit. And then we're going to take that same mixture that's up here. Pull it down. We'll worry about detail and that stuff a little bit later. This is not perfect yet. Things evolve over time, but we just kind of try to get this information down here right now. Okay, this is a sidewalk, or I mean, stairs here, a little walkway, and we'll just use horizontal strokes to, to show that. And this is a little bit darker here beyond it, which in a way will define or can define the steps. A little bit of snow on them, but we don't worry about that. Okay. Continue on. What I see here is I'm doing a little bit of putting in a little bit of orange color. This right here is a cedar tree. It's got a little bit of warmth in it, a little bit of red, reddish tinge. Actually, it's more like a little Alizarin Crimson. So I'm going to put some of that in here. It's cutting across this. It's hard to know what's going on here. So I'm going to show it in the same manner. So I see that some of those reds are up here and up here. Let me see those. Actually, it has a little bit of intrigue to this area. But what it is doing, it is kind of complicating this. I mean, it's not complicating it as much as it's making it kind of nebulous. What the heck's pulling off? Then you realize, oh, it's this tree here that's in front of it. There's some patches of snow here and there. And I'm going to put those in right now. Just so I can help define a couple areas for me. And what's going on. Okay, I see a few things that can be added and so on now, just for intrigue. This branch here is sticking out. Throwing a cast shadow along this tree. Remember, this tree is round, cylindrical, so it's going to have have these darks on this side. Here. See some of the bark area and so on. Whereas it's always going to, as it revolves around the tree, it gets darker. So you can see that essentially what's happening here, you see we're separating the trees a little bit by this blue. A little bit dark here, so more ultramarine blue, a little bit of blue in there, and also as you can see, we've got some darker grays cutting across here. Going to add a little bit of lighter grays. To show it in light. Throw some snow in here. Notice my snow is darker than it is. Probably should be. So we're going to toss in just a little bit of cadmium yellow with some white in here. There's some dirt and so on from my brush and all the, some of these adding a little bit more light there. We're going to throwing some of this. Notice that this shadow is pretty dark here. When you do, if there's snow and so on, typically it's a good idea to follow the land, because that describes the land and also describes, you know, the what's happening with the. With the trees and the, just gonna kind of arbitrarily throw these in, all these shadows in here, same manner as I would do. The same manner as I do a lot of the trees and this kind of thing up here. There's a bush on this side. I'm just going to leave it out, I think. Or I might push it into it, possibly maybe along here. Maybe leave the bush there, some on that order. Yeah, probably something on that order. What I like to do is the snow by right should be always lighter, or typically should be lighter than notice it's put on with a little bit of cad yellow. Save time, if nothing else. And it helps to define, you know, the lay of the land and snow as it accumulates, especially in windy weather and so on. And it has been windy along around here. This is pretty close to home. This place is within 5 miles, 4 miles of my home. It's actually located really, you can never not believe it. This house is only a block away from a Walmart. But it looks like it's out. It looks like it's pretty far out. I have to get some paper towels. I just ran out. And let's see, what do we have here? We've got some more white in here, just a touch of yellow. Yeah. Whoa, putting on a bunch there. Okay. Grabbing another bunch of all right, well, I'm going to take a brush, and just kind of brush some of this snow around where it should be. You want to make sure there's different levels, and the light is hitting down on the snow. So that's going to be the lightest light. Even though we see it lighter, we think we see it lighter, we do see some reflection off here, and we'll make sure that we get that in. But so I use the knife for expediency. There's also a stump in here. I'm not sure whether I should put that stump or not in there. Okay, so we still have a ways to go here. Throw a little bit of snow up on the top here. And it's I'm going to throw a little bit of this white house. You can see that there's nothing yet that approaches the white on my pigments on this thing yet, and yet I'm showing snow, I'm showing all this stuff. So what does that mean to you? That means don't watch out for white. White can kill a canvas in a lot of ways. A window there, and there's a window over here. And there is some lightness to it right there, but you can see that I did not putting in, it just changed into, it's just a smaller paintbrush right there, and as you can see, when light hits a building really harshly, like it is here, it leaves. It reflects off of, in certain areas. I am mixing up a mixture for this right here. And it's about the same mixture as this snow. And I'm putting it in. But I'm going to use a little bit thicker here. See how thick it is? That thickness kind of will reflect a lot more light from whatever source it's sitting in. And because it's thicker paint, now I'm going to go with some of these coming across here, but I want to watch it. Maybe I'll have it just kind of come down. Here a little bit. Not to obliterate too much. There's some very light railings on this house. Don't feel like you have to put everything in. I see something I didn't see before. This is a this actually goes down here. Oh, amazing. I sort of understand this a little bit better now. Oh yeah. Okay. So what's going on there is this come down like this. This comes over here. And this is actually wider here. And what we can do is we can see a little bit that this is a lean-to right here. And I did not know that. Did not look like a lean-to before. I'm blueing this up a little bit back here. And put a little bit of snow on this right here. And there is a window of all things right here. And right there. And that comes over here like that. It comes down. Let's see now. Put a little bit more definition right in there. And right here. And this then makes sense because right here is end. Huh. Well, that's interesting. Sometimes it's hard to see exactly what's in a photo. That's why I prefer a painting. I prefer paintings. Over photographs. However, photographs are nice to use at times because it gives you a remembrance how it looked when you first saw it. So now that makes a little bit more sense over there, and I'm more happier with it. Let's put this, it has more of a crick to it though. This tree is amazing. that's what's so neat about this tree. It's truly got some personality. And it's in front of the house, so we gotta come down here a little bit further. So I'll add a little bit more darks to this area. Very cool notations right there. And I'm going to bring a little bit more definition to this window right here. In fact, I'm going to see a little bit more of it, and I'm going to turn this tree down here more. There, that's better. This tree has this big gnarly thing right here. Hence, because it's so gnarly, I have also named this Gnarly Tree. This is actually, I can see that, I can see more of this, that this tree doesn't really take that turn. So you work with it, you go back and forth to make sure that you got the drawing of that tree accurate. Got to get that tree down there correctly. So I can still see some of this. There we go. Better. That's better. Not perfect yet. So there's some this tree, it has some snow on it and so on. Also, the snow is helping define some of these areas a little bit. So, make up a little bit more here. So this is truly helping me to define some of those edges and so on. And I really don't want people to really look too much at this tree. I don't want it so gorgeous that just so it looks accurate, you know? So here I'm applying the blue of the sky. Okay. I'm just adding a titch of cadmium yellow to this mixture, and I'm not going to have white cerulean and cad yellow, and I'm putting it in pretty thick here. Gotta watch out because a lot I want. I want some of this to read. Like a bunch of branches, very small branches, you know. It appears like the end of the house is right here, so I can have some of the sky come down here. Okay. So I'm going to apply some of that same yellow-white mixture. Into that area. A little bit to define that end. You'd think that it wouldn't hurt to have just a little bit of light there hitting. Some light here. See that the light is coming across here, right? I'm going to yellow it a little bit and I'm going to put it in here a little bit heavier. There, it appears then, because I brighten this up a little bit, that this is a little bit darker, more shadow, and so everything is relative. Just as this, when I place, see it's dark here, so that shadow made by a tree limb comes across, and it's going to be kind of dark there. And of course, you sort of lose the edge. Right? I got a couple things here. Okay, a little bit too heavy here. I'm going to touch that up a little bit. Now, there's no real piles of snow in that picture, but that doesn't mean I don't have to allow some snow to be in there. So I'm putting it up and I'm making it a little bit heavier. Like you didn't come out and shovel at all. As you can see, that looks maybe even better that way. And we're going to very pretty thick. Place some of this snow in here. Now there's a lighter shadow right in here, and we'll just draw that in real quickly. It's all those little things that kind of makes things appear correct. Okay, I'm going to make up another little bunch of them. And I'm going to apply it pretty heavy right there. That looks good. Right here. Maybe that's overdoing it a little bit. Coming down, making a straight edge right here. Darkening that a little bit here. Looks better. There's little diddly things that sometimes make the painting. But you don't want to get, you can see that I'm never futzing with them. I'm just placing them in. Gotta be dark enough to read. If they're in shadow, when they're in shadow. This is, seems to be getting bigger here. I don't think that's good. So I'm going to got these branches and so on. Kind of neat. They're going all over the place here. Okay, now we have to come back and put those in a little bit. Less harshly. Take that one out because it conflicts with the railings and stuff. So all right, let's see. I'm going to put a little bit more coming back with kind of, and I'm working it in though. I'm not gonna leave it there totally. Working it in to that yellow white base. All right, I'm now going to reinstate some of the darks. I'm going to get a I'm going to switch now to round and put a few of these I'm actually putting in some, in the background, some calligraphy, I call it, and it's a straight Alizarin Crimson, which is a very deep red. Could add a little bit of snow and so on to the background trees. A little bit. When I do that, just add that little bit of extra. Streaks of light right here is actually inferring, or it does give the impression that there are fields in the background, there are woods in the background, things are really truly happening there. I'm going to cut a bunch of crossed here. It appears then that there's a lot of brush in the background. Okay. Looks pretty good. Here's then that there's a lot more happening way back there. I'm gonna do a couple calligraphies with this little brush here. Yeah, okay. Gotta watch it myself because you can overdo this stuff. You have to think about the tree and what shape it is so that you know about where to put it. You can define the tree better then as well. These last minute strokes can help. Yes. See, that tree is more modulated and better defined than it was before. There's a dark that should be in here. So I'll put it in. All right. Let's see. All right, I like that. Things are looking pretty good there. Darker calligraphy over here. Yeah. Okay. Maybe a little bit darker browns. There's some darker browns back. So I'm painting this all wet and wet in one sitting. So most beginning artists it aggravates them so much to do that. They think they have to always let it dry. Everything has to dry before they can put anything more in. What about the other artists like Group A and John Carlson and the like? It was all a prima. One sitting, one go. And that's what makes a painting, I think. All right. So, it's nearly finished. I'm putting actually darks in here, and I'm actually putting on kind of thick, which is not normally done. But You want to get them thick enough so that they read dark. They don't seem to want to read dark. As dark as I want them to read, anyway. Put my lights in. Lighter areas in. Some of them. I don't see a lot of lights in there though. I kind of paint myself up too. As you can see, my hands are all dirty and so on. And I get into my painting. So. Add a little bit more blue, a little bit darker there. This I'm adding a little bit here too. Now you want it to pure, like that sun is really hitting it, so. Yes, maybe I should make some of these. Of course, it's both throwing shadows and the sun is also shining really hard, so it's obliterating some of the shadows as well. So it's kind of a funny deal. There's no definition up here, not too much. That's okay. Make sure that there's a couple of these that read really pretty dark. There, I think it's almost it for on top there. You don't want to do too much up there. I do see, though, I do see some. We're going to put in little of those branches that stick out a little bit. Not a lot of them in here, so. Well, some of them to read pretty dark. And then up here they get all twisted and screwed up. And I'm going to add a little bit of Alizarin Crimson to this. And this is where they get kind of all screwed up, right in here. So we'll leave that happen, and that's good enough. Yeah, there's probably, there's a bunch of there, and we'll try to work some of these out. Twisting my brush now, sort of, and then I'll be coming back with some of this. And we'll probably be trying to identify separate branches and so on. But we don't want to get too carried away with that either. I see here that I don't have anything defined here, so I'm just going to get rid of that. Then we've got some lighter branches all over here. Put those in. Got a couple of these. Smaller ones coming off here. there. More definition here. You can see that there's this one limb that actually appears to be something that should be there. Now put him in. And I think he's good. It's a limb that just seems to say, hey, I need to be here. And I'll put on. Some. There, I think that's pretty good. I can see that I screwed up this tree a little bit by doing that. There. So, you see that there's a couple places to make this look like some bushes here. I'm going to do that, and we'll come down with something right here. And let's add a little bit of what I would call snow, just kind of on those branches. Kind of gives a kind of finale or something for that. Is there anything missing there? Well, I think that we could just put this in a little bit better. Yes, we could add some definition there. That looks better, I guess. that helps to define the planes. It's going to be definitely darker, as you can see right here. And with when you're doing it when you're doing it wet and wet, you have to reinstate things kind of all the time. Well, here it is. It's pretty much done. I didn't do much else to it or anything. I did add some more. I'll probably do that right now. Add a little bit But it's pretty much done. Sometimes it's better to stop I think I'm going to add a little bit darker up in here. Yeah, I think that helped a little. Yeah, I think that's it. I'm going to probably, I don't exactly know where to. Sometimes I'm kind of struggling as to exactly where to sign it. Maybe it'd be best signed over here instead of here. This would be a likely place to sign it. In this case, I think I'm going to sign it here. Trouble is, I kind of move into the painting that way, might stop it or just not sure. I'm normally very positive about what I want to do, but in this case, this is a little bit different, I'm wondering what I should. Sign it with. Thinking an orange red. An orange red color. Rather than was thinking maybe Alizarin Crimson. There's a lot of that in here. But I think I'll do it in I think I'll do it on this side. I think that's fried. Looks okay. I think that's wrapped. I'll show you what it looks like. Yeah. Not too shabby at all. So, if you like it, thumbs up. Subscribe. If you're not, come back again. Comment. If you guys comment or ask some questions, I'll be glad to answer them. Have a QA or something sometime. So that's a wrap. Thank you very much. Bye.